I'd like to ask 10 questions.
Okay, keep the one.
I'm going first.
Chief Editor Sangris. One of the things I wanted to ask is to the Willie Lee writing and some of the Yelnef candidates, all Yelnef candidates, but I want to see what their position on. The latest statistic shows that Yelnef has a 0.6 vacancy rate. As you know, just recently, K2K lost a teacher because of lack of housing and affordability. So housing is a major issue for the current population of the NWT. The situation is that people, they want to work. You know, like any, even in Dettah and Geelong, or right across the territories with the First Nations. If they go to work, they have to move out onto the housing. Now, Dettah and Geelong built 10 houses this year. They're sitting empty because nobody qualified. This is from the government that's doing that, the policies. And that any recruitment drive to encourage people to work in the NWT is faced with a challenge due to shortage of housing and the cost of living in the north. Now, I want to ask a question. If elected, what is your solution? What actions would you take to solve the housing needs, not only in Yelnef, but all across the territories, because everybody is facing the same challenge? And the housing needs for the future needs that are factored in people working or moving in NWT to live and to work. What's it?
Right. And it's very similar to a question that we heard a little bit earlier in the evening. Which ridings do you want to direct that to?
Willie and Bob McCall.
Okay, let's do that. Excellent choices. Thank you. All right, we'll begin with Walladay then. Let's start with Bob Bromley.
Yes, thank you, Chief Eddie. This is a key question, and I'm glad you made it for all of the NWT. The biggest problem we have is right now is adequacy and affordability, not availability, because we have a lot of houses, as you say, a lot are sitting empty. So we need to have a new shelter policy, and that's being worked on right now. I was interviewed, as I think my colleagues were, just before leaving the end of our term here. We have a commitment to revise the rental scales so that you can work without losing all of your gains to increased rent. And it's a gradient that's being discussed there. So I think there should be some interesting developments on that. Cost of living is something you mentioned there. That's huge. And to me, one of the biggest ones is energy. Right now, we have rapidly rising fossil fuel costs and a high degree of volatility. And I think by moving to...
Thank you. Mark Bogan of Willowdale.
Thank you, Chief Sangris. Again, what I was saying before is one of the things I propose is to change how we conduct ourselves within the civil justice system and the Department of Social Services. I mean, our Governor General just spoke to the Law Society of Canada and advised them that they had to heal within themselves. That's $40 to $60 million a year. That's going to buy a lot of homes. And I agree with you. I've been up and down the valley many times, and there are a lot of empty homes. And so that's $40 to $60 million a year to help fix up those places that have been abandoned. That's really a solution that I've been echoing throughout this campaign, that everybody's trying for money, and this is one way to accommodate affordable housing. Thank you.
Thank you.
Merci.
And our candidate for Yellowknife South, Mr. Bob McLeod.
Thank you, Chief. I've
already been elected, so. But I'll answer anyways. Housing is probably one of the most important, difficult issues that this 17th Assembly will be facing. I think everybody aspires to owning their own home, and in the Northwest Territories, it's very difficult to achieve that objective because it's very expensive, not only to own and operate a home, but also to build one. Over the years, this government has taken a number of runs at it. Our biggest problem is the CMHC that's been referred to earlier about 15 years ago, negotiated their way out of housing so that within 40 years, the CMHC will provide $0 for housing in the Northwest Territories. So I think the shelter policy, we've put in market housing in every community. Those houses are staying empty.
And that's time. Thank you. And thank you, Chief, for your question.